Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and me and my helper, Hi. Logan, are going to be drying some of the squash that we picked yesterday in the garden. We have a food dehydrator. This is one of the shelves for it. And just to help keep the dry fruit food from sticking, I'm using some cold-pressed olive oil, just a light coating, on each rack. And my helper will be putting them on the rack for me as I slice them up. We'll start with this one. Okay. So we've washed them already, and now we're just going to do about a quarter of an inch, trying to keep them evenly thick so that they all dry about the same time. Okay, now Logan, you're going to put them on here, not touching each other, but close.
They look like coins.
They do. Garden doubloons. Now, after we have the trays all filled, we'll be putting them in the food dehydrator, and they'll have to dry about 7, 8, maybe 9 hours, depending on how fast they dry, how many we have in there, how much humidity is in the air. So all these factors determine how long it takes.
Now, does it matter that you mix, I hate to say species, but, you know, different varieties?
No, I don't believe so, as long as they're all the same thickness.
So some don't have more
water content
in them than others, where they would dry faster?
Well, they might, but since these are so closely related, they all have pretty much the same. Now, this one feels soft to me, which Logan pointed out when we were washing it. So, now let's see. I think you can put them a little closer together and all the way to the edge so we can put a few more on here. I'm just not letting them touch because we need the air to be able to come up between them.
Because they're going to shrink to
They will shrivel.
Maybe, what, at least a half their size, if not more?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we'll just...
Now, why would somebody want to dry or dehydrate their vegetables in summer?
Well, because with zucchini especially, these are kind of shrivelly, so I'm not going to use those. With zucchini especially, they all come ripe at the same time, or you could get overwhelmed with how many you have. Your neighbors will only take so many, and you don't want to have them go to waste. I mean, you've waited all winter for them to get ready.
You mean all summer?
Oh, no, you waited all winter thinking of how wonderful they were going to be, and then all of a sudden you have too many. Now, you could also take a bigger zucchini, which we'll show later, shred it up on a food grater, and I'm told you can dry those also, but I think I will just freeze those. Okay, next layer. Start all over again. You did very nicely on that one. Let me get these. Oh, get in there. Why is that not wanting to go where I want it?
I have to turn it around 180 degrees.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you are so smart.
That's why they pay me the big bucks.
I know. That's why we keep you handy when we're doing these things.
Well, man has to be worth something. I mean, you know, now that women are in charge of the world, I mean, you know, we have our function in life.
You do. You keep us going.
You remind me of a woman.
What woman?
Woman with power.
What power?
Power hoodoo.
Hoodoo?
You do.
What?
Remind me of a woman.
What woman?
Logan?
Yeah?
You remind me of a boy. Boy with the power.
What power?
The power of hoodoo.
Hoodoo?
You do.
What?
Remind me of a boy.
Oh boy.
Chima.
This is how we amuse ourselves while we're doing mundane work.
Every day.
Every day?
All day.
All day?
Yep.
Okay, get them a little closer, see if you can squeeze in some of those smaller pieces here.
Okay. This one and...
No, these are good enough to nibble raw, right?
Well, you could, yes.
Yeah,
people
probably.
Put them in salads and things. Okay.
I tell you, when you saute these
right
in butter,
right here.
And then, or grill them on the grill, mm-hmm. and then you sprinkle Parmesan cheese on them.
Yes.
Oh my goodness.
How about, one fit right there, maybe if I. Perfect. Excellent. Okay. Start your next tray. Now every now and again you'll come across a bruise or something and you may have to change the shape, or if you decide that you wanted a different shape, they wouldn't have to just be slices, they could be cubes. You like a variety. Now what would you use these for? Mostly I would say in stews, soups. We've never actually tried rehydrating and then sauteing them. That might be something we would try in the future, just as an experiment. Now let me cut these in half so that give us variety here.
Is this a little side trick here?
This is our little snack.
No, that's what I call Coca-Cola. And what are you adding?
Creamer.
To keep my help happy. A little more. Now, obviously, as you do different shapes, you're going to get different drying times. So that's why I'm putting these smaller pieces, which will be done much faster than this large piece, but I'm putting this tray on top so I can easily access it and take out the pieces that are done as they finish. But until then, well, that's okay. We'll build on this one. I can always rearrange the shelves as I need. Okay, now I'm going to be doing this patty pan squash. I've never dried these before. Obviously, I'm not going to get the same shapes as I had there. And these tend to have more seeds in them, as do the delicatas. They're very firm, especially the longer you leave them on the vine. And they get bigger, they get more firm. So if you're going to be preserving them by drying, then you have to pick them when they're a little bit small, like this. These might be better if I just slice them.
Slice and dice?
And they're slippery, so to be careful. Okay, that might be too thin.
Now, what if you left them that size?
You could, because they're all the same kind. Do you want to eat this size in a soup?
Probably not.
So I think I may just cut those in half. These seeds seem to be okay. I don't think I'll have to take these seeds out. But again, I cut these thinner only because that was easier so I didn't cut myself as I was slicing them.
One of the questions I've always had is, they always talk about people throwing away the best part of their fruits and vegetables, you know, with the skin, having more vitamins and minerals and whatnot.
All the nutrients.
Well, what about seeds?
Well, seeds would be the same, but you have to remember that seeds aren't always palatable. They're not some, if they're hard, your body's not going to be able to process them anyway, and we'll just eliminate them. Plus, it makes the eating experience less enjoyable. So,
what if you oysterize them and put them in a smoothie?
I suppose you could do that. Why not?
Especially if you're freezing these, you know, you just put them in a smoothie.
If you were, yes, if you were freezing them. I'm drying them.
Right.
We could try freezing them also. I think you would probably have, if you were freezing them, you would probably have to parboil them first to stop the enzymes.
And parboiling means?
It means like boiling them for several minutes just to stop the enzyme production of rotting.
Okay.
I'll have to look up how to do that and if I need to do that, because with green peppers, I know I have just in the past put them on a chop them up into pieces, put them on a cookie sheet, frozen them, and then taken them off the cookie sheet and put them in a plastic bag without parboiling.
Well, maybe you should experiment with just a couple of these pieces and see what happens. Instead of drying them all, you know, just take a couple, put them on a cookie sheet and put them in the freezer and see what happens. These actually look very, very tasty.
They are. And they're pretty.
Yes.
And now for the delicata. These are called Zeppelin Delicata squash. These are the very, very creamy. Creamy, smooth. When you eat them, you're expecting them to be like a zucchini, and yet they're not. They're like a cross between a butternut squash, which is very creamy and sweet, and a zucchini.
The first time you made one of these, I think 3 years ago now, when we first got our first one, I had no idea what I was biting into, and as did our younger son too.
You thought it was going to taste like a zucchini.
Yeah, and I mean, it just really changed my palate. Wow. I mean, that was so smooth and buttery. In fact, I don't even remember what else I ate that night. All I remember was the delicata.
Both of you ate the delicata before you ate anything else on
your
plate.
Yes, it was absolutely spectacular.
Okay, shall I keep them whole?
Why not?
Okay.
And always cut them up, I guess.
As you can see, our helper has found better things to do. So we've been abandoned.
Yeah.
But that's good. He has an idea of what we're doing, and before he goes home this evening, he'll be able to see how much these shrink down, which is what I wanted him to see.
You know, it's so important for children to get involved with food and gardening, and now, not only to understand where it comes from, but also how it's processed. I mean, for me, this is an education. Not that I haven't seen dehydration before, but you know what I mean. It's always interesting to watch.
Well, and it's fun to try different kinds of foods, too. I mean, we've done zucchini before. We've never done the delicata or the patty pan.
You know, what we really have to do is refine our batch for zucchini candy. That went over really big a couple of years ago, and we haven't done one since.
Well, last year we had no zucchini.
Oh, that's right. That's why. The drought.
The squash bugs in the drought took care of our zucchini last year, so we had none. Which was very, very hard to go a whole summer without your own zucchini. We did end up buying zucchini from the farmer's market, but not the same.
Nope.
Just picking them yourselves.
Remind me of spaceships.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they are.
Maybe they are. Keep my fingers in the way here. Now see, you can see that these seeds are getting a little more developed, so those might be leaving us. Okay, and for this, I think I will just cut around the seeds. So now we have smiley faces.
You just want to get artistic here.
And these are getting kind of thin, so. Well,
maybe we'll have to use these this evening in our salad.
Is our base of operation here. Get them growing. Or maybe not. It tricked me. There we go. Okay. These are our top ones. Our other ones with the small pieces are up here. Okay, and I'm putting it on medium. And they're kind of on their own now for approximately 7-8 hours. We'll check them before that just for those little pieces and just so that we can show Logan how they will look when they're done. It's fun. It's a good thing to do with your kids. See you later. We would take a look at these after 3.5 hours. Take the cover off. You can barely tell the difference, although if you touch them, you can feel that they are definitely drier and starting to shrivel a little bit. Like this one. A little shrivelly. Oh, back goes the cover.
So you said about 8 hours?
Mm-hmm. So they have 5 hours to go. About 5 hours.
Okay, we'll check back.
Okay. It's the next day. Yes, they're still cooking, or drying as the case may be. We came out about 9:30 last night with our flashlights looking to see if they were done, and they weren't. Well, we didn't want to let them go hours and hours longer, so we turned them off, left them as they were. It was in the 40s last night, so we weren't afraid of spoilage. Then I turned them on first thing this morning. And you can see, especially these little bits, they are finished. So until I get them into a mason jar, I'm just going to put them in a freezer bag. And you can see that they are tiny enough to fall through the cracks. As you put them on, you have to be careful and anticipate that so they don't go all the way to the bottom. This one is a little leathery. It's probably done. I seem to let them go longer.
So how crispy do you like them?
Well, I don't think they're supposed to be crispy. I think they're supposed to be leathery. And these are getting crispy. So these have probably gone a little too long, but that just means that you have to reconstitute them longer.
If they do get crispy, couldn't you take them and basically grind them up into almost a powder form?
A zucchini powder? I suppose you could, sure. And just add it to salads or soups or on bread. It might be interesting mixed with olive oil and put on bread. Let me try one of these crispy ones and see how they even taste. That's pretty much way too done. They're not bad. Much healthier than potato chips. No, crispy. You want to try one?
Yeah.
All right. Try this one. It's hard.
Okay.
Okay, here you go.
Oh, it is crispy. It is like a potato chip.
Mm-hmm. Now, consider
zucchini
to put
chip.
A little olive oil, spray a little olive oil on there and some salt. That'd be very good.
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a spray olive oil? I know you have a little container that you put your olive oil in and spritz it.
Right, that would be a good idea.
Oh, that is right. Very tasty.
Now, let me look at this batch. Ones that had the little bit bigger pieces. Now these are definitely
softer.
Softer, right. Let me look at some of the, even these quarter pieces are soft. These are done. These were the delicata that I took the seeds out of.
Could I try one of those?
Sure you may. I will also. Those are chewier.
They are. Completely different texture.
Mm-hmm. And sweeter.
Yes.
So these are very well done, so I'm going to put these in here. And I think the ones that aren't quite as crisp but more leathery, I think I will put those in a bag or a bottle by themselves. Aren't those cute?
Yes, they are.
I'd be very cute in a stir fryer and a soup. All right, let's look down here. Oh, and here's the ones that were little. Yep, these are all crispy, so these could go definitely with these other crispies. Now we have a three squash soup that we can make. The delicatas, the yellow squash, and the zucchini. So, not bad for our first time of the season. On to new things.
Well, I'm glad we have zucchinis this year.
Maybe tomatoes next.
Ah, yes.
Well, if you've learned something, give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching. We'd love to hear from you, and subscribe anytime.
Now, if you were here, you could do some taste testing of your own.
Good. I just don't know if I should let this go a little longer or not. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll just take these
just
more finished ones off, and then I'll condense my trays.
Okay. On to the next project.
On to the next. Bye-bye.